Hello, welcome to another episode of Plenty with Sulo. Today we have a personality and she is Nayana Karunarathna. You're well known in Sri Lanka, right? And people know you as someone who makes women beautiful. But actually, who are you?
Well, professionally, I'm a hairdresser and a beautician and a teacher. Otherwise, I'm just a Sri Lankan woman.
But you had made many opportunities for women and you have inspired many women. Not only women, I would say men also. But you know, you people look at you as I see you are being there for as a judge for competitions. But more than that, I have seen your speaking and it's very unique. So I want that Nayana Karunarathna to speak up.
I think the secret, first of all, I have a mouth which I can talk. But I think the most valuable thing is I only say what I feel, I believe. And I have a real passion for sharing. I have a passion for sharing and I really like to part with my knowledge. I don't have, in fact, this my earliest students and staff used to say, Nayana kavadavat guru mushtiye tiyagatte ne. So maybe that's my way. I have a feeling it's my mother and of course Janet who has given me that guidelines, I would say.
Yeah, because it's hardly when people become successful, they remember the people and you're one of them.
Every time I take a step forward, I've also been very lucky, Sulochana, because when you go higher in life, you meet very smart, educated people. They yeah. come to that position because they are smart and they are educated and they are very clever. And most of them are most humble, most simple. And I am very fortunate to be in the World Federation of Hairdressers. I am the Asia Zone President. So I really hobnob with the top people from 77 countries. Every time it really brings me down to see how simple, how ordinary and how wonderful human beings they are. They are the best hairdressers in the world. So it really humbles me and I think that has really helped me.
How all this started? Because did you wanted to be someone like this?
Or? A hairdresser?
Yeah.
I think definitely I wanted to be a hairdresser. I can't remember when it was, but it is definitely somewhere when I was around 14 years old. But my mother says that as children we all played with hair, so
yes.
that is natural. Doll houses and all that. Then Archie Kondida, Havarida, Eva Karano. But before O levels, by the time I was 14, I was very sure of doing. I really can't remember why, but I think it's seeing one or two brides, you know,
okay.
who I used to be taken for weddings and you see the brides and then actually I think it's fate. At a wedding we met Janet.
Okay.
My mother knew Janet. I had not sat for O levels yet. My mother knew Janet and she made the mistake of telling Janet about me, this child is very nice, happy. This Janet said, after O levels is the best time to start. 30th of January, I'm starting a class. If you like, you can send her. I took it very seriously. This must have been September, October. So our exams are in December
yeah.
and during the holidays. So I told all my friends, listen, I am not coming to school. I'm going to do hairdressing. I had decided 30th of January, I'm starting the class. And you know, those days now we had after the last day, we had a party and a biryani packet, five
yeah.
rupees and yeah, green cabin chocolate cake. And they gave me gifts also, handkerchief boxes and all rubbish. So I got into the car and got hammered, chatter, 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 my mother. What nonsense is this? You had to go back to school. I said, are you mad? I'm not going to school again. I think both my mother and I were both embarrassed. Then she, I think, took me seriously and she sent me to Janet. So by the time the O-level results came, I was already employed with 50 rupees salary.
Oh.
6 months course. We got our results in August. So I was already with one month's salary.
So you had a vision of
very much. I was very, very clear about what I wanted. I had no regrets. I think it was quite a shock to my mother, I think, because we come from a family of scientists. But you know, I think it's all her life experience also, because she got widowed when she was very young. And she had this thing about all four children. We are two girls and two boys. You had to be professionally qualified. Mm-hmm. You have to be professionally qualified. And the two girls, if you don't have to work, it's okay not to work. But you have to be able to stand on your own feet if the need arises. So she was crazy about all of us. I remember when my younger brother, she sold our car and sent him to Germany to learn printing, because she was crazy about the qualification. So when I did this, she said, okay, you do hairdressing, but one thing, you have to be world-class qualified so that you are employable anywhere in the world. I think that was good advice. And so, I had a fantastic teacher also.
Yeah, it's not just about your passion. No, it's about getting the qualification and everything.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you can drive a passion, but you have to have that qualification to drive a passion.
You have to. In any field, you have to be qualified. Even to be a cook or anyone, chef or something. I mean, when you say chef, not in a hotel, but to be a good person, you have to be. You have to be knowledgeable. Very important.
Something that Sri Lanka has to understand. Just that qualification, passion, or your job, whatever you do, you don't need to be employed. But as a human being, do you have that knowledge to live your life?
And the simplicity, I think that I'm fortunate to have got that also from my family. So I think we are very...
That simplicity I have seen you.
See, I do come from a very highly... All my uncles are professors. We are all very... very highly educated and holding good positions, but I didn't realize it, because we grow with them and we don't realize it. But when my grandmother died, we are from Kalaniya, so the Kalaniya temple Hamduru, he came and he was saying, this house is the most illustrious house in the Kalaniya village, because this house has the most qualified, smartest people, but this is the simplest house. We don't see tamasha, we don't see cars, we don't see shows. We have the simplest people in the village lives in this house, but this is the most illustrious house in the village. And of course, all thanks to he praised my grandmother. But that day I really realized that is true. My mother was the first English speaking graduate to come to Kalani.
Okay.
So like that, then I have professors in my family. So all that is not relevant, our simplicity, I think it has come from the family. I'm really proud of that.
That's something that's really proud of that. I think that's what you drive, because I seen you whenever you speak to a girl who is like from Colombo, is different when someone from village. I have you just don't ask. You inquire what's her background and how she does, because I was sitting with you for a judging and I realized the Nayana Karunarathna people thinks and the real Nayana Karunarathna is a two different person. So you have been like, you know, you are being very close to these people. What really made you to, you know, you're not just, okay, I'm a beautician, I'm high class. You're not sitting on that. But you go out of your way to build these young people.
I can't pinpoint what it is, but I think it's a middle class background. As I said, even my mother's side, my grandparents are very simple, so are my other family members, and so my father's side. I think the fact of giving, fact of teaching, the contribution is from my family, my mother, and a lot from Janet also. Giving and sharing. And I am here, I only think because I am born to a middle class family and an intelligent parent. My father died when I was 7 years old. So intelligent mother who guided us properly on the right way. So that's the luck. And I see now, as a hairdresser or a beautician, there are so many people who are 100 times more talented than me. So I see a lot of them who have no opportunities, so I like to give them. Second thing I see is so many of them. When you see 10 Sulochana, only one will survive. All the others will crash. I mean, either drugs or bad management or poor discipline or no commitment, or it's very, very sad. So as much as possible, I like to part with what we have, and the upbringing we have had, lots of people don't have. And the current situation in this country is the lack of self-worth in our people, general knowledge, self-worth, self-pride, and the value for self. That's the reason. So if I can do even for 10, 15 people, I'd love to.
Lot of women choose the entrepreneurship as hairdressing salons, and they are opening up. But I don't see them, after they open up, I don't see them getting the qualification, getting themselves upgraded, or managing it properly. How do you see this?
You told me that I am different what people see, because I think in the hairdressing industry lots of people don't like me, because I have for the last 22 years we formed our first, maybe 25 years we formed our association 22 years ago. From that time the purpose had been development of the industry. See, to our industry, people come with less education. It's not a disqualification. You can have 5th grade or 8th grade. It's okay as long as you are talented. But along with it should come education.
Yeah.
And education doesn't mean to say you have to have university degrees. Education, knowledge. Yeah. So at a very young age, and at very early, lots of people make loads of money. You have no idea how much they make. So much money they make. So if they get lost. So a lack of ability, awareness, managing. So, you know, we are very much like these mason, basun, and carpenters. How much do they earn? Much more than you and me. But they don't know to manage themselves. They have no finance management. They have no time management. They have none of those things. So same thing with the hairdressers. So some of these girls stay at home, work for 2 days a month and earn more than us.
Yes.
Or rather, may I say, a teacher or a office staff. So they don't know. So ara singalen kiyanne antattu awa kiyala or adi ibbada pihatu awa kiyala e wage you become pompous. You have money, and money gives power, and you think you are super powerful, and that's where we have gone wrong. So everything is very cheap, very low in quality, and also short time. Most of them crash because there is no saving. See, these all of us have our peak only for a certain time. Right? So after that it comes down, it balances. So you need to be ready for that. You need to balance, you need to divert, you need to do all those things. We are having a constant struggle for the last, it took us 2 years to do the Sri Lanka standards for the industry. And it's got passed now, SLSI standards, and we have the gradings exactly like for hotels. Nobody's discriminated. Even a barber salon to a top salon, the grades are there. You just follow them. And when you are at 4, if you want to come to 3, there are ways of developing for next year. Huge opposition to implement that. Huge opposition. They don't understand.
Yeah.
They don't understand. Even as an example, I'll give you a barber salon. What we are asking is drinking water. Wash your comb with tea after each haircut. Yeah. Wash your towel. We are not asking for air conditioners, nothing, because it's a small place.
Yeah.
So, karanne, it's not there.
That's
people are scared of paying income tax. They are scared of paying EPF. They don't know. You won't believe. Chambers of Commerce, bank. With whom we are working, Women's Chamber, all these people have approached me to ask for small and medium loans for the hairdressers. How to give? They don't operate bank accounts.
Yeah.
They are scared to pay taxes. They are scared to register. So how to get bank loans?
That's one of the reasons, because when I go to rural, when I ask whether it's registered, they say, no, we have to pay taxes. Then I explain to them there's no taxes or something. it's just that 1 year payment you have to make, and yes, it's a very small amount.
Very small amount.
But some, I don't know, if they do not know, they are not getting awareness, they are not educating themselves. But after 1 year, if I go back, the salon is not there. So that is one of major issues, and everyone is following, because I see a lot of programs in going, and 100 to 200 people are attending. But how many are being employed or being employed?
See, and the other thing is, you know, Sulochana, I always tell people, we are not doctors, we are not comparing ourselves, but we are the only ones who are allowed to touch the human body, even though it is from the outside.
Yeah.
It's a big responsibility. So health safety standards, where are they? How can you touch a skin without knowing the structure of the skin? People don't know. Putting makeup, you can do for your daughter, you can do for me, I can do for you. That's not an issue. Put some pins and flowers on the head, that's not an issue. But you can't cut, you can't color, you can't perm, you can't do a facial without the knowledge. So this is the thing. When we just about 3 months ago, when we got the final document from the government to register, about 15 of the very prominent people went and protested and said this cannot be allowed. So, but anyway, of course, we are not sitting back. We are trying to make the people understand and do it. So it's really very hard.
It is very hard, but we need to have something, because
it's a very good industry. Yeah. It's a very fast growing personal care, fast growing industry, and very lucrative, lots of money. But if it is streamlined, so many people will benefit. See, people say they are opening salons and they are closing salons. I won't accept that, because I believe that Sri Lanka still does not have enough salons. Okay, if you take Gola, Matara, doesn't have. But the salons that are there don't serve the people. Just imagine 21 million people, okay, let's say 10 million out of that, these ladies, let's say 5 million out of that, these ladies, and maybe 2 million men. Every month, one blow dry, one eyebrow trim, one waxing, one person only once, one facial. What money are we talking? What money are we talking? We have 95% of the ladies going to a salon only on the day of the wedding. But imagine just one waxing, one threading. So we need lots of salons, but we need quality services.
Quality. It's not the quantity, it's the quality. Yeah.
And not only bridal. Bridal is good business, but you can't depend only on bridal.
Yes.
You have to have the daily requirements of everything else.
Yeah, I agree. Now with this, all these beauticians and everything, you stepped into this personal, personal development, yeah, and, you know, building the personality and what to shop, what not to shop. So what made you to come to that side?
Actually, pretty accidental. I am a beautician. I always wanted to, and I applied for this Air Lanka job as a beautician. Air Lanka at that time. And I thought I'm going to be the beautician of, you know, makeup and hair. And when I went in, I realized it has nothing to do with hair and makeup. Teaching hair and makeup is just 2 or 3 hours job. It is a case of maintenance of the air hostesses or the ground handling staff, the maintenance. We don't do their hair, but we get them to do. And why are they not doing their hair and makeup, and why are they smelling of body odor? Attitude. It was attitude, number one. Number two, lack of knowledge. So for the entire 9 years of my life at Air Lanka, I only taught personality development by way of positive mindset, attitude and hygiene. Have a bath, use deodorant. There were air hostesses who used to go to Paris and come with one lipstick and one eyebrow pencil. Once I remember a girl came with a slit at the back of the blouse. What to do, Nayana? This is the tailoring. How can you say that? Doesn't it happen to you and me? You buy this dress, I buy this sari. We are not going to walk with these things. And then the rule of an air hostess is to carry one extra set of clothes. Because there might be drinks, there might be vomit on the... No. Attitude. So that's where... And I worked with the training division of Air Lanka at that time, which was a fantastic you need to successfully run with lots of foreign trainers. So I learned a lot. So I really realized that what is most needed is the attitude and the training on personality, health, hygiene. Those are the things. And not only Alanka, the entire country needs it. That.
Yes, that's what I wanted to say.
Entire country,
because sometimes the hygiene is something people ignore. And they do not understand that their hygiene can be an issue for their withdrawals also.
Yeah. More than ignore, I think it's a habit. Now this hygiene is a bath problem, no?
Yeah.
Bath and deodorant. I have discovered it with my work. Okay, it's a habit. Now, what every mother, I always say, every mother says to a child is, Nakrinda putte, that mother muna kata hodagan inda putte is kole and. So if you look according to Unilever statistics, 95% of Sri Lankans brush their teeth in the morning, which is a fantastic number for a nation. Habai moona kata hodala yanne moona kata hodala
no nothing
na iti moona kata hodala where is school giyala me then moona kata hodala wedata yanawa. They have a bath once a day,
yeah,
but most of us working people go and have a bath at 6 o'clock. Children go and have a bath after school. Then it's the next day, 24 hours. The women at home, the housewives, you have heard of the huchakku story.
Yeah, yeah.
They have a bath, they remove their huchakku and have a bath at 2 o'clock in the afternoon just before the children come from school. So that is a habit. Lots of people don't know that.
It has already gone to the subconscious, yeah. Say, when you wake up, you only have to brush your teeth and
So we have to change that. I always say, even the teledrama, we have to change and tell people, have a bath and go, start the day, I would say, not go to sleep, and have a bath and go to sleep.
Yeah, that is. Because that's something I also always speak to the
always,
women. Because
always.
That I have seen mostly, there's a lot of family issues come up with
of
that
course.
Hygiene. So coming up, now you know that we speak about women, their entrepreneurship, but as a mother, you know, you how do you see the future of your children in Sri Lanka?
Well, I have two boys. One of them is already here. The other one wants to come. Unfortunately, he's married to an Indian girl, so he's a little stuck in Australia. But I had to send my children to Australia to study because not study is only the university, because we had the JVP problem 89-90,
yeah.
So all the universities were closed, and so it was not a nice thing, but I had to do that. But they went to school here. They were diving champions, rowing champions. They were very much local boys. One of them have come back. I still think I can talk proudly because I migrated myself when we were young, and I came running after 2 years. So nothing like this country. I am here. This is my country. I'll put in my 100%. We are unfortunately governed by some not so smart people, otherwise we are a fantastic country. But we still have so many good people. I look at it in a different way. I was young and pregnant when I was with my second child when the 83 riots came. So prior to 83, life was good. I was not witness to 56, but up to 83 we had a good life and balanced. You know, we had grandparents, parents going out, this, that, and the other. Life was good. And we didn't have special, but I think, as you know, every day was an education. Don't do this. Lassanta kanda, indagena putre vaadila kanda. Everything was taught to us. So then, of course, 83 came. And I still would say that I was okay. But there were so many people affected, including myself. We all only wanted to survive. I mean, you send the school to children to school, and you just wait for them to come home. Lots of people wanted food on the table only. So I don't think we had time or
to groom
the heart
our children.
To groom our children. That's number one. Then where the country's political situation is concerned, I strongly feel LTT was very smartly got rid of the future leaders. They were very smart to not only the top level like Mr. Laji
but the lower level who had the ability to change the country, the potential.
Yeah. So now, 35 years later, there are new leaders who were born in 83 or who were in the Montessori at 83. So now there is a good, smart lot. So I think we are okay. We should only find that leader. There are educated, good, committed people in this country who can lead us, who are in their 30s and early 40s now.
There will be a time, because I think Sri Lanka always has faced this and come out.
Yes.
And we have taken it as, yes, we go take a backward, but we bounce back in a very
I only have one observation which I think you and I and whoever can do must do. As I told you, all this has given a lot of lethargy to our people and the children. You know what, I'll just tell you something that happened today. One of my staff, and we have special classes for them, one of my special classes, training classes, come to work on time, come to class at time. He doesn't come, he comes at 12 o'clock. It's raining. I didn't have an umbrella. This is a 23-year-old man telling me. Of course, I had to ask him to go to, but this is the society today. So, but I'm not angry with them. We haven't taught them.
Yeah.
Schools, parents, no one has. So I think that has to be launched island-wide, where people have to be made to understand their values, motivation. We have to get them pumped up.
I agree on that. Thank you, Nayana, for sharing. I would say the sharing your view of entrepreneurship, business aspect, and the country future aspects. And thank you so much for the time. Welcome. There's a cup next to you with a pen. If you can sign with your name.
This one?
Yeah. The other side. Yeah. You have a small gift from Plenty with Sulo and a cup which has the Plenty with Sulo slogan, and I hope you will enjoy our tea. It's
yes,
a Sri Lankan
course,
tea always. Today we had Nayana Karunarathna. She spoke about the future of our country, not only the future. She said attitude has to change, because attitude becomes our habits and habit become our values. If we can change our attitudes, we can change our future. I hope you all enjoyed it. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Plenty with Sulo. Thank you. Be safe.